I want to show you some ways savvy business professionals are using AI to help with their everyday and sometimes boring tasks to be more productive. And they are mind-boggling easy, these tactics I'm going to share with you. We're not talking about automating your AP function. We're talking about stuff you can do yourself. Stick around until the end when I'll share one really fun tactic that really has nothing to do with work, but I'll bet you never thought about doing it, and I know I never did, and it will change your cooking game, even if you are a chef's nightmare in the kitchen. All right, back to work, if you will. Tactic number one, analyze data. You can use AI to help you analyze data. So this is what you're going to do. You're going to go to ChatGPT, and then you're going to attach your spreadsheet file to the dialog box. You'll see that there's a little paperclip in the left-hand corner. You'll click on it, and then you'll attach your file, okay? And then you can ask questions. Now, keep in mind, you can ask questions. Keep in mind the tips that we discussed in the prior session on surviving and thriving in the business world, the tips for using AI. I'll link to it in description, and if you're watching on YouTube, it is in the top right-hand corner. So let's say now we've got our Excel file uploaded, and we're using our accounts payable example. So you might ask it to identify duplicate payments if you've uploaded your vendor your payment file, for example. If you've uploaded your master vendor file and you're looking for duplicates, you might ask it to identify duplicate vendors, based on name. You might also ask it to, is there the same tin in more than one account? Ask it to look for duplicates. And then when you find the same tin taxpayer identification number, you could investigate to see whether those were duplicate vendors. Okay, number two, when we're on talking about analyzing data, or I call it B, you could ask it to analyze the data. You can first try just uploading the data and ask it for any insights, see what it comes back with. It may come back with some things that you never thought of, but you probably want to be more specific. So you could ask it questions depending, again, on the data that you've uploaded. So if you've updated one which includes vendor invoices, which invoices contained an early payment discount that you didn't take? But again, you need to be precise, making sure you're using the right terminology, the terminology that you were using in your column headings. And you can ask it whatever questions you want related to the information that's in the file that you've updated. And the last thing when we're talking about analyzing data, you know that old saying about a picture's being worth 1,000 words? Your AI tool can help. If you've uploaded the data, you can ask it to create charts for you. You can tell it what type of chart. Do you want a line graph? Do you want a pie chart, etc.? Or you can ask it which type of chart does it think is best for a particular type of data. You may or may not agree with it, but it'll be interesting to see, and then let it create the whatever the graph is for you. Okay, tactic number two. Now, you can use ChatGPT to write macros. Now, this is a touchy issue because how much longer we'll be writing macros is open to debate. Some experts think we'll continue to have to do them, perhaps aided by AI tools. Other things that this will go away, and we'll be able to use the query and analytical aspects of AI. They'll be that good, and so we won't need to write macros. We'll see. Time will tell. Regardless of the outcome of the date of this debate, you can use ChatGPT to help you write the macros. Tactic number three. Do you hate going through your inbox and responding to emails, sometimes regurgitating the same or similar email to several different people? Or do you find yourself slaving away far too long responding to an email, either from an executive or a recruiter, because you're looking for just the right phrases, you want to make it just perfect? You may know the points that you want to make, you just, as I said, need to craft the response exactly. Well, ChatGPT to the rescue. Copy the original email, copy and paste it in, and then go to your favorite AI tool. It could be ChatGPT, you might use Microsoft Copilot, whatever you're using. I'm sure there'll be some new ones coming out. Paste it in. Then you can say something like, please respond making the following points, and you can list them out. And when the tool spits out the response, you can review it and tweak it where necessary. You don't want it to say something that you didn't intend. You can then say something like, make it more, make it a little friendlier, make it more professional, whatever. You can. But I always find it gives me a good starting point, but then I absolutely tweak it several times, because also you want it to sound like you, not like the AI tool. Okay, tactic number four. Do you have large documents to read, but you don't have the time, or you have a large boring contract, you know, you have to go through it, can't afford to miss any important point, and inevitably that important point is buried in a mass of unimportant mumbo jumbo. Again, the AI tools can analyze a lot more than numbers. Load that contract into the AI tool, either copy and paste it or use that little paperclip on ChatGPT, and ask it to analyze the documents, give you some salient points. Then you might ask it, what are the points that might cause problems? What else would you ask when you were having it review documents? Let us know in the comments below. Tactic number five, how often have you taken a picture of a slide, either at a conference or on a video call when someone holds up a slide deck, and then you have to transcribe the information from the picture? That's often tedious, and sometimes you can't read the handwriting. You know how that goes. But once again, AI to the rescue. It can extract text from images. So again, using that little paperclip tool, attach the photo and ask it to transcribe the writing in the picture and give me the text. That's what you can ask it, and then you'll have that done. Tactic number six, and I really like this one. It can serve as a sounding board, a best friend, or even advisor. You can get honest feedback from an AI tool, feedback that a friend might be hesitant to give you for fear of hurting your feelings. You can show it two things and ask it which is better, maybe two versions of the same email, two pictures if you had them, if you were doing something graphical. You could, for example, you might ask it if you had two versions of the resume, which is more likely to get you selected for an interview for a job as a manager, or if you have two paragraphs, which is more likely to have my boss give me a raise. You can also paste in anything you write and ask it, how could you make this stronger? Whenever I do my scripts for the podcast, such as this one, I will put it in and say, what would you suggest that I do to make it stronger? You don't blindly accept what it suggests, because sometimes the suggestions aren't good, but sometimes it is good. But let me be clear, it doesn't help with the tips. So for example, I recently did a talk on 8 tips to reduce duplicate copies of an invoice. And if I left something out that was obvious, it's not going to point it out. But it will help you with your wording. It won't help you with the content. If you've missed something important, it probably won't be able to find it for you. Tactic number 7. This might be my favorite of all time. Do you get frustrated sometimes when you're looking for some basic information and you're doing your searches and all you get are advertisements for people trying to sell you a product or something like it? I was recently trying to figure out if my daughter needed a prescription for a certain type of painkiller after she'd had some surgery. And all I kept getting were these advertisements trying to sell me a non-prescription type, okay? And it was beyond frustrating. So I turned to Microsoft Copilot and I simply wrote in, do I need a prescription for it? And I put it in and it came back and it said yes. It didn't try and sell me anything. It said, you need a prescription. Simple, that's all I wanted. So when you find yourself in this all too common predicament, now you know where to go. Go to Microsoft Copilot, ask the question. Okay, and now for the fun part, and I really think that this is fun, and I would never have on my own have thought to do it, and well, you'll see what you think, and you'll see if it works. Let's say you have a picture of some delicious looking food. Maybe you saw it on the internet, or maybe you were out to a meal at a restaurant where they're not going to give recipe, and you have it, so you take a picture. Maybe it's a cake, maybe it's a delicious looking pasta dish, whatever. You can ask AI for the recipe. Will you get the exact recipe? It depends. Maybe, maybe not, but it might be close. Let me share what I did with you. I had a special dessert when I was visiting Salzburg several years ago with some cousins. I believe it was called Three Mountains. If you're watching this, I put the picture up on YouTube. So you can see that my picture isn't anything perfect. So I attached the photo to ChatGPT and asked it, can you tell me what this is? And can can give me the recipe. It came back and told me that it was likely baked Alaska, and it gave me the recipe for baked Alaska. Now, to be honest, it wasn't a bad guess, but I knew really what it was. So I tried again, and I said, if I told you the picture was the Three Mountains dessert served at St. Peter Steiskolliarium, and I did not say that right, in Salzburg, could you give me the recipe? Now, if you don't know, and I didn't know until we visited, this is one of the oldest restaurants in the world, and Christopher Columbus is reputed to have eaten there. What do you think ChatGPT told me? Here's what it came back and said. Thank you for sharing the additional details. It's very polite, by the way. The dessert you're referring to is the Three Mountains, or Dreiberge, which is, again, how they is the German name, which I probably did not pronounce correctly, and it's served at St. Peter's, here we go again, Stiftskolinarium, again, my apologies, in Salzburg, Austria. This dish is a local specialty and a signature offering at one of the oldest restaurants in the world, known for its rich history and fine cuisine. While the exact recipe for Three Mountains dessert is likely a closely guarded secret of the restaurant, it generally features meringue peaks resembling mountains. Here's a recipe inspired by the likely components of the dessert using a meringue-based approach similar to what is served at the recipe. And then it proceeded to give me a recipe for what it called Three Mountain Dessert Inspired Recipe. Now let me tell you, I looked over the recipe. It looks pretty much like what we had. I hope you're using AI at least a little bit, and if not, I hope I'm inspiring you to get started. To help you in that regard, three links will appear on the YouTube screen. They are the tips that we published earlier on using AI, and also two on one to how to get started with Microsoft Copilot, and another how to get started with ChatGPT. We'll be back later this week with a session on how to use AI in your job search, and another one on why you need to learn to use AI right now. Good luck.